please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
How can your money make more money? That's a very important question, especially when your life goes through uncertain times. Where do you go? Who do you ask? Well, that's why we're here. Hello and welcome to NSC FinWiz Season 5, powered by CNBC TV18, where we help you understand various concepts of financial planning. Today, we are at the headquarters of one of India's leading IT consultants, DATAMATICS.
DATAMATICS is a global name in consulting, IT, data management and business process management services to more than 500 companies. Founded in 1975 with its headquarters in Mumbai, DATAMATICS has beaten the streets across America, Australia, Asia and Europe. With the highest standards of service quality and operational excellence, DATAMATICS has enabled its clients across a wide range of industries to transform into truly digital and data-driven enterprises. NSC FinWiz with its team Dream On engaged with the techies at DATAMATICS Mumbai to understand their aspirations and help them fulfill their financial dreams.
Financial literacy is, I think, very critical because most of the professionals are not in the field of finance. And finance has really matured. There are so many different instruments, so many different options and permutations, each one having a different risk factor, each one having a different implication. So I think it's very important that young professionals get early involved with the financial modeling, the financial analysis, so that as they earn more money and as years pass by, they become more and more mature.
I would like to ask the experts whether it is safe to directly invest into the stock market or the commodity markets.
So my question for them would be, how to choose the best investment plans among those in the market? How to have a knowledge on that?
I would like to know how much percentage of my earnings should I save to achieve my goals.
Welcome to NSC FinWiz Season 5, powered by CNBC TV18. We are at the offices of DATAMATICS, and today's topic of discussion is savings versus investments. And to shed some light on that topic, we're joined by two experts in the field of financial planning, Kalpesh Asher and Pankaj Matpal, and of course, a very eager audience ready to ask their questions and doubts to our experts. So let's quickly kick things off on the topic, savings versus investments. Kalpesh, debunk some of the myths which are associated with these two concepts for the professionals here at DATAMATICS.
So savings versus investment, when we say that, what's the difference? I think you could put it in two lines, that one that is the very thin line between the two. So if you feel that you are saving something, it's more of an emotional, I would say, upliftment, that you are saving something at the end of the day, but that is more for a protection and a more of a conservative feeling. But when you say that you are investing, you are into a thought process which is very evolved and which takes a lot of maturity. So savings versus investment could actually be summed up in one thing, that saving is a feel-good emotion, whereas investment is hardcore action.
Now, Pankaj, coming to you, how much percentage of savings should ideally be transferred to investment as a starting sort of step for the people here who say, okay, I've got X amount in my savings, now what do I do with it?
See, first thing is that from your salary, make a point, around 30% you should definitely save your money. Whatever you're earning, around 30% try to save it. If it is more than that, if you do not have responsibilities, you do not have EMIs to pay, maybe that you are able to save more than this. But at any point of time, try to save at least 30% for your future goals. And other way is that calculate your goal, how much money you need for that to save, to invest that you do. And out of that, only that 3 to 6 months of your monthly expenses you should have in your liquid assets for emergency. Other than that, you should invest in different asset classes based on your time horizon, risk appetite, or objective of investment. It's not only equity, it's not only debt, it's not only gold, in different asset classes, but you should invest that money.
All right, and Kalpesh, as Pankaj said, there are different asset classes. There's a universe of options available for average investors. Now, when, say, savers, people who usually save, come to you and say, when I want to invest, but they do not have a starting point, and let's say they have not framed up their goals as well. But as a sort of a startup act, what's your pitch to them as to how to convert savings into investments?
Everybody's financial life and profile is different. Earning capacities, liabilities, goals, ambition is different. Understanding your own mindset, your own goals right now, and then putting that in front of your professional advisor or something. Once you have that clear, even the advisor will be able to more effectively answer your questions and provide solutions. So if you have a short-term goal, the answer is liquid funds, what we discussed, your even savings account. You could keep the money in those smart FDs which we have, those type of instruments, and achieve that goal. You don't want to risk that money. But if you expand the horizon and say that I don't need this money, which I'm saving every month for the next 10 years, then equities is the answer in all probability. You don't have to look beyond that. So that is where the first step of transition comes, the knowledge part. Knowledge of your own self, and then the knowledge of the markets. For knowledge of the markets today, we have various means. If you can't do it on your own, please hire a professional who will handhold you, who will guide you. And the bottom line of it is, whatever you earn or spend should have a purpose. It can't be just floating in thin air that I'm spending for the heck of it or I'm investing for the heck of it. No. There has to be a purpose. If you can afford the spending, if it gives you happiness, it is ethical, do it. If the investment is ethical, if it gives you liquidity, if it helps you achieve that goal, do that and cut down on your normal savings and everything. Invest hardcore, invest for the long term.
For an investor, when they say if they had invested in debt funds as a relatively, safer, I'm not saying risk-free, but a relatively safer investment product, their point of view would be about, if the returns are tepid, why not just put it back in a savings account or an FD where I get an assured, interest rate, and I can tell myself that it's above inflation and my money is growing on. What would you say to them?
Your fixed deposit may give you 7% fixed. Sometimes it sounds very good. It is giving me assured 7%. But look at it in a different way. It is restricting the performance at 7% only. Means do not have scope to earn more than that. See, this debt investment last 1 year might not be good, but if you see overall, they have always delivered better than your fixed deposit. But most important is that understanding why you're investing. Second thing, sometimes people say, I do not want to take risk. But by not investing in equity, if you're investing in fixed deposit, you are taking bigger risk. That is risk of inflation. So risk of inflation is bigger than risk of volatility. There is a guarantee if you invest in fixed deposit, after 20 years, 30 years, you may not have sufficient money for your retirement or other goals.
And on that note, we'll take a short break. But when we return, we'll be dwelling more into savings versus investments and talking about, say, retirement and tax issues on that. Stay tuned. We're discussing savings versus investments. Kalpesh, tax planning is, of course, an important part. But unfortunately, when people look at investments, they sometimes focus on it too much, focus on the tax planning asset too much. What should they be doing? I mean, tax planning is important, but again, you're kind of missing the point if you're focusing all of your investments just on that one aspect, right?
I think we should look at the main tax saving avenues which we have. Let's first focus on the ATC, and the limit there is 1.5. First is they offer you insurance premiums in that. But if you pay a term plan premium, say 15,000, 20,000 premium, your life is protected to the maximum. Then you move on to ELSS in the mutual fund. So there's no limit there. But even if you want to allocate, say, 30, 40, 50% of that, so hypothetically 25, 30, 40, 50,000 rupees in ELSS and thereby take an exposure for the long-term wealth creation, there's an opportunity there. Third, it also has a provision for providing for the tuition fees of your children. Then you come to your mandatory EPF, which is deducted from your salaries. Now, EPF as on today is the most highest interest yielding instrument today amongst all the safe avenues which we have. Then you move on to a bank FD in case if there's a senior citizen, and 5-year bank FDs are given there. So people who do not wish to take any of these calls, even a 5-year bank FD is available to you to avail of the ATC. ATD, your health insurance. So you have a limit of 25,000 there for yourself and your family, and 30,000 if you're paying premium for your parents. Then you go to the loans part. it has to be seen in entirety, that if you are actually looking for the house, you have that limit on the interest, which is allowed up to 2 lakh rupees, avail of that. There's a section 80TTA, which helps you get the savings on your bank account interest up to 10,000 rupees.
So I want to add one thing which is missed out here. You all must be investing 1,50,000 under section 80C. But in addition to that, under section 80CCD1B, you can invest up to 50,000 rupees NPS. In NPS. So that additional benefit you can avail. And for your 80D, 5,000 rupees on preventive health checkup, like your ECG, blood sugar, etc. And that also you can claim under same section.
All right, it's time to get the audience to list out their goals. We'll be calling out your names. You can get up and list out the goals that you have mentioned. Give us a bit of history about yourself and give us a few details about the goals that you have, and our experts can look to answer your questions. The first name I'll be calling out is Prafulla Bhole.
My goal is to make money in 10 years horizon, 75 lakhs to 1 crore.
Okay.
I'm investing monthly 22,000. Per okay. month.
By investing 20,000, if you consider 12 to 15% return, it may not possible to accumulate 75 lakh okay. in 20 years. But simply if you keep increasing your investment by 10%, 7%, because I expect your salary will also increase year after right. year. So similarly, if you increase your investment every year by 7-10%, it will be possible to achieve your goal.
The next person I'll be calling out is Ambika Iyer.
My goal would be planning for retirement and considering to accumulate as much as you can around 20-30 years of span okay. and with say 20 to 30,000 per month is what I look at.
Ambika, basically you should set a target. Now that target setting itself is a challenge, and for that financial planning is the answer, in which there's a systematic process and the process takes you closest to your goal, which you would like to have as a retirement corpus, and the path to taking it. So what we do in financial planning when we do the retirement planning process is, we take the present set of expenses and add inflation to it with the time left for your retirement. Okay? And add inflation to it with the time left for your retirement. Okay? That would give you a estimate of what your retirement corpus would look like, factoring in the point that you would also have inflation and you would also be investing simultaneously.
Final audience member I'll be calling out for this segment is Chetan Bhanushali.
I would like to know that where should I start and what is the amount that I should invest?
The amount you want to accumulate is 7 lakhs.
7 lakhs.
And on a monthly basis, how much can you save?
Around 12 to 15,000.
12 to 15,000. And your time horizon is?
Three to four years.
Considering that 3 to 4 years you have in hand and that too you want to invest for higher education, where you cannot postpone that goal also much. Okay, so you should invest in balance fund okay. or some other hybrid fund where equity allocation is limited. Okay. This kind of through SIP route. Every year, keep increasing that.
On that note, we'll take another short break. When we return, the floor is open to all the working professionals here at Datamatics to ask any questions that they might have to our panel of experts here. Meanwhile, stay tuned. Theme of discussion is saving versus investments, and the floor is now open to the members of the audience here at Datamatics to ask any questions that they might have to our panel of experts on savings versus investments.
My question is that we all keep parking our funds in the different mutual fund schemes. But everybody is confused about the periodical review. So can you suggest what are the right time to review that, the whether whatever our hard money has been invested is heading to the right direction to achieve our goals or not?
Answer to that is that, you know, when should you review it? Once you enter the field of or the universe of mutual funds, I think automatically you should take a bit of a view that this is going to be managed by professionals. They have taken the burden off your shoulder. It is their responsibility to deliver the returns. And obviously, you need to keep a track of the economy. You've taken a call into mutual funds. Review the portfolio at least, I would say, once in a month for sure, a thorough review. I think once a month, if you have an advisor who sends you a report, have a look at it once a month, see the fluctuations, understand the motive why you've invested. Is it heading towards that? If there's a deviation, why? So as we say that higher agony or higher ecstasy is not good. So even if it has gone up, question it. Even if it has gone down, surely worry about it. But don't panic and take decisions without understanding the motive, because you might have a lot of fluctuations in equity. But if your goal is 10 years, you can just review it and keep mum. Because you know if the economy is going to turn around, the cycle is going to turn around, it will be in good waters. There's no two ways about it. Do a review, but decide after 1 year.
All right, I hope we have answered your question. Let's see more hands. You have a question? All right, let's have one here and then the gentleman in the pink shirt after that.
My question is, like, we have not touched the areas like the gold and the property as an investment versus saving.
Now, gold as an asset class does not have potential to deliver very high returns. See, prices of gold go up based on the dollar and rupee exchange rates. If dollar price goes up, because we import gold, we do not produce gold in India. So in your portfolio, if you want to have 5 to 10% gold to beat inflation, you can have, but it does not have potential to deliver you good returns as good as in equity. Then again, in gold also, instead of investing in gold coins or gold bar, there are gold bonds or gold ETF, gold mutual funds, where you can invest. Real estate, comparison of real estate with mutual fund is not the right comparison, because in mutual funds, you start with 500 rupees, 500 per month, you can invest in SIP. For real estate, that itself is a goal, that you plan to buy real estate, for that you invest in different schemes.
I believe there was a lady in the back who had raised her hands.
Yeah,
yes, sure. If you could get up.
I have a 3.5-year-old son, so I would like to plan for his future higher studies. So which one is better? There are lots of child plans present in the market, or go for FD or mutual fund?
The simple answer is equities.
Equity, okay.
Okay, so nothing of a child plan, nothing of what you need is a term plan for yourself.
Yeah.
You are an earning member. Tomorrow, if God forbid something were to happen to you or your husband, your child would need protection,
yes.
Not the other way around. So equities is the best answer for it. Even a small amount, whatever you designate for him out of your earnings today, over a 15-year period in equity mutual funds will do a world of good. And with your income rising, you can always add on to that. Simultaneously, don't forget, you also have to plan for your retirement.
Yes, yes.
All right, the next person I'll be calling out is Yvonne Gonzalez, if you could get up.
If you say for senior citizens, like for my parents, at this age, like they are senior citizens, 65 years, so what would be the best way to invest for them?
We need to create our own retirement corpus. For that, equities over a 10-15 year period are fabulous. Absolutely fabulous way to create wealth. Just to put something in perspective in figures, I'll just tell you that if you are investing in equities for just a simple amount of 10,000 per month, this will show you the power of compounding. Okay? A figure of 10,000 per month, if you invest for 15 years, so you start at the age of 45, and that equity is growing at a very conservative 12% per annum, CAGR, which is not very high. 12% is just beating your inflation by 4-5%. That amount will give you a corpus of 50 lakh rupees.
All right, on that note, we'll wrap up this episode of NSE FinWiz Season 5, powered by CNBC TV18. We've been discussing savings versus investments with our experts here, who I'd like to thank for sharing with us their insights. And of course, the working professionals here at Datamatics for a very engaging Q&A with the experts. And of course, the viewing audience at home watching this show. Stay tuned, lots more perspective, lots more insights on financial planning coming up on this show. Thank you for watching us.
First of all, I would like to thank the panel and CNBC for such an informative and wonderful program. It definitely gave us more insight into what are the different financial options available in the market right now.
Good event, crisp, to the point, and it really helped me bring in a fresh perspective towards my own investments, because earlier I used to typically think what worked for for my teammates would work exactly same to me, but now I realize that no, I have thought about it wrongly and I need to customize my investment plan according to my goals and requirements.
I really like the event very much because it gave me